नियतिकृतनियमरहितां श्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आददति भारती कवेर्जयति. सो वी आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द लास्ट् फ्यू अर्थदोषास् दट् आर् लेफ्ट् विच् आर् विध्ययुक्तः अनुवादयुक्तः त्यक्तपुनःस्वीकृतः एण्ड् अश्लीलः. सो विध्ययुक्तः, the word itself is, it is, it can be very confusing with avimrishta videyamshaha, but in avimrishta videyamshaha we have seen that it specifically it denotes to with the, it how do I say, there it is padam and here it is artham. So that's the only way you can differentiate it. Let's look at the shlokam, then you may have some more doubts or it might get cleared. Yatna paribodhitah stutivihi adyasheshe nishame akeshavam apandavam bhuvanamadya nissomakam iyam parisamapyate ranakatha adya doshalinam apaitu ripukanana ati gurukaha adya, it should be ati gurukaha adya baraha bhovaha. This is a statement by Ashwatthama. He tells Duryodhana and says, you know, today you can sleep. See, he's angry. This is all based on after that incident where Drona is killed. And then Ashwatthama says this shloka. He's so angry and he says, I will destroy the entire Pandava army along with Krishna. So you can sleep very well. Duryodhana is the king. And he says, Duryodhana, you can sleep really well tonight. You don't need to feel afraid. And you will be woken up with a great effort by your Stuti Pataka. The people who wake up the king, those Stuti Patakas, will have to make a great effort to wake you up because you will be sleeping fearlessly in a peaceful manner. So, yatna paribodhitaha adya stutibihi yatna paribodhitaha, by the stuti, by all the praises that usually the stuti pataka do, with that you will be woken up with a great effort. So adya nisham sheshe nishavyaptam nidrasi, you are going to sleep during the entire night tonight without any effort, without any disturbance, and it'll be very hard, very difficult to wake you up. Adya bhuvanam akeshavam apandavam nissomakam cha karomi. These are all, you'll have to understand the verb here. So I am going to make this world without Keshava, without Pandava, and nissomakam. None of the Soma Vamsha, Chandra Vamsha people are going to live in this world. That's how I'm going to create a destruction in this world. So, iyam ranakatha doshalinam ranakatha api adya parisamapyate. The ranakatha, the story of war that is being that is there, that is doing its round around brave people, doshalinam, those who all are very valorous, those who are strong. तेषां मध्ये दोषशालिनां मध्ये या रणकथा प्रचलति सा अद्य परिसमाप्यते. ऐ विल् सी टु इट् दट् नोबडि स्टार्ट्स् अ वार् और् नोबडि कण्टिन्यूस् द वार् एण्ड् मै आक्षन् टुडे विल् स्टाप् वार्. भुवः भारः अद्य अपैतु, एण्ड् द बर्डन् दट् दिस् भूमि इस् बेरिङ्ग्, what is that burden? Ripu kanana ati gurukaha bharaha adya apaitu, let that burden that this earth is carrying be removed. And that burden is actually ripu kanana, it is a forest of enemies that she has, and because of which that weight that she bears is ati gurukaha, it is extremely unbearable or very heavy. The heavy burden that this bhumi is bearing till now, let me get rid of all the kshatriyas who are creating a burden for her. Na atra shaitaha prayatnena bodhyase iti vidheyam. So vidhi ayuktaha, in the sutra where he enlists the dosha, he would have said vidyanuvada ayuktaha. So you have to split it as vidhi ayuktaha and anuvada ayuktaha. In vidhi ayuktam also, there are two ways in which the vidhi vidhyayuktatvam can happen. One is, so that samasa is vidhehe ayuktatvam. Vidhehe, vidhi, whatever should be expressed as a vidhi, or that which is vidheya, that which has to gain prominence in a sentence or in a meaning, that is not vidhi vishayatvam. Or avidheyasya vidhi vishayatvam. That which need not have a prominence has gained prominence here. That is one type. The other is vidhi ayuktam means krama avidyamanatvam. The ayukta krama kramatvena yojaniyam. That is the second example that he is going to give. So here videhe ayuktatvam or avideyasya videyatvam. What is that? Now, adya, the sentence is such that yatna paribodhitaha or prabodhitaha tvam adya sheshe. You being woken up with a great effort, you will sleep today. That is the meaning that we get from this sentence. The actual meaning that should have been is shaitaha prayatnena bodhyase. Bodhana kriyayaha eva atra videyatva. So, shayana kriya is not important here. That he is sleeping is not important. You will sleep and you will be woken up with a great effort. That waking up part should be much more important than sleeping. So when he has put it in that samasa and the way he has constructed it, actually there is another reading that has been suggested. One minute. The Vyakhyata says, where is that? I was reading something and then... So very nice reading. Shaitaha, not this one. Prayatna paribodhitaha. Okay.
Sukhena shaitas chirad ushasi magadaihi.
Yes, correct. That's the reading that I was looking for. Correct. Sukhena shaitaha chirad ushasi bodhyase magadaihi. Sukhena shaitaha. You will sleep very peacefully, happily today. Ushasi, in the during the dawn. Magadaihi bodhyase, stuti patakaihi tvam bodhyase. Then it makes more sense. You're going to sleep and you will be woken up in the morning only by the stuti pataka. So which means until now, because of constantly thinking about how Arjuna is going to defeat him or how Yudhishthira is, because of that jealousy that he has, it was very difficult for Duryodhana to sleep, first of all. So he would have slept and then he would have been, he will wake up. He will be woken up with a great effort. Whereas here, sheshe means nidrasi. You are going to sleep well. Being woken up. So it could also be that you woke up and then you are sleeping now. That is the idea that is being conveyed here. So it is actually a viruddhartha pratipadakam. That is the problem in the shlokam. Puriyadha?
அந்த அதுக்கப்புறம் ஒரு லைன் போட்டிருக்காரு அப்படி வாட் இஸ் தட் அவிமிருஷ்ட விதேயாம்சே து யுக்தஸ்ய விதி பரம்
அவிமிருஷ்ட விதேயாம்சஸ்ய யுக்தஸ்ய விதிஹி தட் விச் கேன் ஹேப்பன் இஸ் அவிமர்ஷ மாத்திரம்னா த மீனிங் ஆஸ் சச் whatever has to be important, the importance is maintained there. Yuktahana yedukku vandu oru idu irukum edhu nyayama vidhiya irukkanumo adu nyayama vidhiya irukku avibrishta vidhiya amshathla, but it is just gained an apradhanatvam avladha. Whereas here, whichever has to be used as a vidheyamsha, it is not used as a vidhiya. It is
okay. So adha vidhiya sollala. Okay,
it is not even used as a vidhi here.
Okay.
शयनस्य विधि अविषयत्वं किन्तु अत्र विधिविषयत्वेन उक्तं बोधनस्यैव अत्र विधिविषयत्वं च. Next is that akramata. It's a very interesting shloka. Vataharataya jagat vishadharaihi ashvasya nisheshitam தேக்ரஸ்தாக திஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனதர் டைப் ஆஃப் விதி அயுக்தா வேர் தி தெர் இஸ் அன் அயுக்த கிரமத்துவம் சோ வாதாஹாரதையா ஜகத் விஷதரைஹி ஆஸ்வாஸ்ய நிச்சேசிதம் தே கிரஸ்தாக புனஹ அப்ரதோய கணிகா தீவிர விரதைஹி பர்ஹிபிஹி தே அபி க்ரூர சமூரு சர்ம வசனைஹி நீதாக க்ஷயம் லுப்தகைஹி தம்பஸ்ய ஸ்புரிதம் விதன்னபி ஜனஹ ஜால்மஹ குணானு ஈஹதே. See, there are snakes in this world which live just by breathing in air, but still they are being destroyed, yet they completely destroy this world. Snakes are capable of killing people. So jagat idam nisheshitam, nisheshitam nisheshataya nashtam kritam kaihi vishadharaihi sarpaihi. So, vataharataya ashvasya, you trust them because you trust the snakes, thinking they live on air, they don't need anything else to eat, yet they kill people and they destroy this entire world. Vataharataya, because they eat air. That is a kavisamaye angikritam. So, kavisamaye sarpaha vatam aharataya swikurvanti iti prasiddham. So, vataharataya prasiddhena ashvasya, you trust them, you trust the snakes, but what do they do in turn? Vishadarehi idam jagat nishyeshitam, it has been completely destroyed. So, vataharam means you are eating only air, means it is the tapasaha tibratvam. It shows the severity of penance that the snake follows, because it is going to be applied in an aprastuta way or in a Arthantranyasa way, where you're going to say that people still want to pursue penance. So those who perform the severe penance, like the snakes, which eat only air, you trust them, but they destroy the world. Te api, te punaha vishadharaha. So those snakes, again, are being caught, grastaha, by barhibihi, by peacocks. So peacock and snake has an enmity. So barhibihi te punaha grastaha. These snakes are again caught by the peacocks. And what is the peacock famous for? Abhratoya kanika tivravrataihi. They perform the tivravratam, the penance of drinking only water that comes from cloud. So just toya bhakshanam, toya panam or jalapanam, only surviving with jalapanam is another form of penance. Next, te api barhinaha, those peacocks also, krura chamuru charma vasanaihi lubdhakaihi kshayam neetaha. Lubdhakaha, hunter. Hunters who are wearing, you know, the krura chamura. Chamura, chamuru is a type of deer, chitra mrugam. तस्य चर्म वसनतया ये धरन्ति ते लुब्धकाः. दट् चमूरु चर्म इस् क्रूरं. क्रूरं मीन्स् परुषम्. इट्स् वेरि रफ्. सो दोस् हण्टर्स् हू वेर् द रफ् डियर् स्किन् दे किल् दीस् पीकाक्स्. नौ वेरिङ्ग् डियर् स्किन् इस् द फस्ट् स्टेप् फार् पेनन्स्. सो दे आल्सो फालो सम् टैप् आफ् अ पेनन्स् दिस् हण्टर्स्. नेक्स्ट् इस् जस्ट् लिविङ्ग् आन् वाटर्. That is followed by the peacocks. Living on air is followed by snakes. But we see in this world that all these three people are violent criminals. They perform violent actions here. So, dambhasya spuritam vidannapi. Dambhasya, dambham gives a nice explanation here. Shatyena dharma acharanam dambaha. Shatyena, by deceit. A person who follows dharma by deceit or by a very in a parahimsa rupam. So those who perform dharma in a very deceitful manner, or they show people that they perform dharma and they get the trust of people and then kill them. The kooda irundhe kuli parikkiradhumba tamilla mari. So shatyena dharma acharanam dambaha. So dambasya spuritam cheshtitam vidanna api, vidanna janan vetti janaha दम्भस्य स्फुरितं चेष्टितं वेत्ति, तथापि जनः किं करोति, जल्मः जनः दुष्टः जनः गुणानेव ईहते धर्ममेव आचरितुम् इष्टे. So he wants only to pursue good qualities, even though he knows that those who have those good qualities and are trying to perform dharma, actually, in reality, they perform cruel actions. This must be some Bauddha who is writing this shloka. Vataharataya jagat. Now, what is the problem here? अत्र वाताहारादि त्रयं व्युत्क्रमेण वाच्यम्. सो व्युत्क्रमेण वाच्यम्. नाउ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द तपस् गोज दिस वे. द नॉर्मल थिंग इज यू डू ऑल योर नॉर्मल बिहेवियर, बट यू वेयर डियर स्किन एंड यू डू तपस् और मेडिटेशन एंड दैट्स ऑल, बट यू ईट व्हाट यू वांट टू, यू ड्रिंक व्हाट यू वांट टू एंड कंटिन्यू लाइफ. दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ तपस्. द नेक्स्ट इज लिविंग ओनली ऑन वाटर, नॉट ईटिंग व्हाट यू वांट. Then living only on air, not at all eating. So the Tivratvam should be in the reverse order. Then it would have been better. Because if it is on the reverse order, then the Chamatkaratvam is lost. It is very similar to that. You remember where Matangane Vadadatu Athava Ashwana. Give me either elephants or horses, something like that, where the vyutkrama, we saw that krama viruddhata, that is there in the padam. Here the whole meaning is the contributor, the tapas and connection to ahita acharanam or himsa acharanam is the problem here. So that, with that connection, if the kramam is in the reverse order of intensity, if we had had the hunters in the beginning and then the barhi, then at the end snakes, even those people who live by eating air, still they perform bad actions. So why do people want to go behind dharmacharana? This is just a sarcastic way of saying. Sariya, you get the meaning?
Idellame tapasodiya kruratvam vandu descending a vechiruka instead of ascending.
Yes.
Okay.
See, when it is in the ascending order, so you will normally expect people who are at the lower level to perform bad actions. It's okay. They konchu munna pinna irukum. It's fine. As you go further into the tapas, then even those people who have controlled their senses still perform himsa kriya. Then it is more chamatkaratvam, and the effect of the arthantranyasa will be even more. There's no point in saying, you know, hunters are performing himsa actions, why are you doing this? There's no point in that. Next is anuvada ayuktaha. Are rama hastabharana bhasala shreni sharana smara krida vrida shamana virahi prana damana सरो हंस उत्तंस प्रचल दल नीलोत्पल सखे सखेदः अहम् मोहम् श्लथय कथय क्व इन्दु वदन. The context is some people, some vyakhyata are saying that नीलोत्पलं प्रति विरहिणः पुरूरवसः उक्तिः इयम्, but it is not found in विक्रमोर्वशीयम्. There is no other text that we know of which has पुरूरवस as the hero. A kavyam which has Pururavas as a hero, maybe someone can write later. But for now, it is just a shlokam that is just found like in Subhashitam or something like that. So, are Rama Hastabharana. So, he is addressing the Nilotpala. Hey Nilotpala, Sakhe, O friend, Sakhedaha Aham. I am very upset here. I am so upset here. Moham Shlathaya. And remove this confusion for me, because the moment I look at you, I feel you are my beloved. But tell me, where is she? Kathaya. Moham Shlataya means remove that moham that is there in my mind. Kathaya kwa indu vadana. Tell me, where is that beloved of mine who is like a moon? So, all of these are adjectives for that Nilotpala, the blue lotus. Rama Hastabharana. Rama Lalana. हस्ताभरण ललनायाः हस्तस्य आभरणरूपत्वेन भासते भासते. सो ईस् अड्रेसिङ्ग् नीलोत्पल एण्ड् सेयिङ्ग् यु आर् दि आर्नमेण्ट् आफ् द लेडि भसल इस् भ्रमर. सो भ्रमरश्रेणि शरण यु आर् द हौस् आफ् बीस् फार् द रो आफ् बीस्. स्मर क्रीडा व्रीडा शमन. यु सप्रेस् द Vrida, Lajja that is there during Smarak Krida, during this love sports. So when people, when the Nayika and the Nayaka get together, where if the Nayika feels excessive Lajja or shyness, she can mask it with this lotus in hand and as if to play with it. So Smarak Krida Samaye, या व्रीडा तस्याः शमन त्वम्. सो वित् दट् इन् हेण्ड् शी मे बि मोर् रिसेप्टिव् टु लव् स्पोर्ट्स्. विरहि प्राणदमन. दोस् हू आर् सेपरेटेड् फ्रोम् देर् लवर्स् यु डेस्ट्राय् देर् लैव्स् बिकास् दे फील् ईवन् मोर् ग्रीफ् वेन् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द नीलोत्पल बिकास् दे केनाट् जायिन् वित् देर् बिलवेड्. सरो हंस उत्तंस. हंस मीन्स् श्रेष्ठः. हंस सरो हंस सरो श्रेष्ठ उत्तंस. यु आर् लैक् एन् आर्नमेण्ट् आफ् द बेस्ट् आफ् लेक्स्. इफ् वि से अ लेक् इस् ब्यूटिफुल् आर् इट् इस् द बेस्ट् लेक् इट् मीन्स् इट् शुड् हेव् अ ब्लू लोटस् इन् इट् आर् अ ब्लू लिलि इन् इट्. सो यु आर् लैक् द क्रेस्ट् ज्वेल् उत्तंस आर् द आर्नमेण्ट् फार् अ लेक्. प्रचल दल. Your leaves are petals are moving. Prachala, it is slightly moving. So the moment it is moving, it feels like, you know, the Nayaka feels it is responding to his questions. So he is talking to that. He doesn't understand the difference between Chetana and Achetana Vastu. So he addresses the Nilotpala and says, Hey Sakhe, Sakhedaha, I am very sad. Moham Shlathaya, remove my confusion because I think you are her eyes. So tell me, where is she? She is Induvadana. Kathaya Induvadana Kva. Shloka is very nice. So, Atra Virahi Prana Damana Iti Na Anuvadhyam. Anuvada Ayuktatva means the Visheshana is not appropriate here in the sense. See, he is asking the Nilotpala to remove his confusion, Moham. He is asking the Nilotpala to remove the confusion means he can't say that the Nayaka or the speaker, the Vakta, Virahi. And the, how do I say this? Ravana is a destroyer of the Devas. The Devas can't go and fall, surrender under him and ask him to protect him. He is actually the destroyer. It is like that. So, virahi pranadamanaha neelotpalaha, neelotpalam pranadamanam, tatraiva prarthana ayuktatvat. So, anuvada ayuktam. So, you cannot repeat that as a, it is not appropriate for that visheshana to be repeated. There are so many other visheshana that will enhance the qualities of the Nilotpalam, but you are asking the Nilotpala to help and moha shlatanaya prarthanaya. Then if the Nilotpala destroys your life, then it doesn't make sense to go and ask it, right? Puriyada? Next. These are all simple shlokas. Chule.
அனுவாதஹனா இங்க வந்து சித்தஸ்ய உபன்யாசன்னு போட்டிருக்காரு. சித்தத்துவம்னா இது நம்மளுக்கு ஏற்கனவே தெரியுமா? கவி சமயத்துல நீலோத்பலம் வந்து என்ன சொல்றது,
விரஹினாம் பிராணதமனங்கிறது தானே நமக்கு சித்தம்.
அதனால
all of these adjectives that he has said are siddha vastu. So that which we know before, it has been established that Neelotpala or Kamalam is an Uddeepakanam. Vipralamba Shringarasi Uddeepanam, it has been established. So that you don't need to say it here when you are asking it to remove your viraham or your moham. It is not appropriate there. இஃப் யூ இட் இஸ் லைக் அட்ரஸிங் ஹே ராவண தேவநாசக அப்படின்னு கேட்டுட்டு யூ கான் கோ அண்ட் ஆஸ்க் சரணாகதி தேர். அதுதான் எனக்கு சொல்ல தெரியும். நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் தி ஃபேமஸ் ஸ்லோகம் லக்னம் ராகாவிரதாங்கியா. வி ஹவ் சீன் டூ த்ரீ தோஷாஸ் இன் திஸ் ஸ்லோகா பிஃபோர் ஐ திங்க். நவ் ஹி இஸ் கோயிங் டு பாயிண்ட் அவுட் அனதர் ஒன். தியக்த புன ஸ்வீகிருதஹ தியக்தஹ புனஹ ஸ்வீகிருதஹ ச தியக்த புன அர்த்தஹ தியக்தஹ அர்த்தஹ புனஹ ஸ்வீகிருதஹ சேத் தியக்த புன ஸ்வீகிருதஹ இதி தோஷம். சோ நவ் வாட் இஸ் தட் ஹியர் விதிதம் தே அஸ்து வி நோ தி ஸ்லோகம் சோ ஐ அம் நாட் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் இட் டூ மச். So Tatsaktaha, I am the king who is constantly behind that sword, or he is attached to that sword. He is not at all thinking about me. This is the talk of Rajalakshmi, and she says she sends the Kirti as a duti to Samudra. Now te viditam astu, let this be known to you, which means she has conveyed whatever she has to convey, then she has to stop, right? She again takes up tena asmi, means tena tasmat karanat athava tena iti ragnya. So we have to again go back to the earlier meaning and bring that ragnya iti you know that meaning is continuing here. So ye tatsaktaha ayam na kinchit ganayati viditam te astu. You have ended the, and it is a meaningful sentence which has ended there. You are again pulling that tatsaktaha ayam, that ayam portion is again being pulled here, and you are using that meaning here and taking it again. So tenasmi datta brityebhyaha is a reiteration of the same meaning that you you pulled from the earlier one. Okay. So tyakta punah tyakta punah swikritah. Okay, now we have one more here which is ashleelam. Atra viditam te astu iti upasamhritah api, even though it has been stopped there, even though the sentence has been stopped, tena ityadina punah uvartah, it has been again taken from there. The last artha dosha that we are looking at is ashleelam. हन्तुमेव प्रवृत्तस्य स्तब्धस्य विवरेषिणः यथा अस्य जायते पातः न तथा पुनरुन्नतिः अत्र पुंव्यञ्जनस्यापि प्रतीतिः. द लिटरल् मीनिङ्ग् इस् एव्रिथिङ्ग् इस् एन् अड्जेक्टिव् टु अस्य अस्य पातः जायते यथा अस्य पातः जायते यथा पुनरुन्नतिः न जायते तथा पातः अस्य यथा जस्ट् लैक् इन् अ मेनर् दट् ही केनाट् गेट् अप् अगेन् पुनरुन्नतिः यथा न भवति तथा अस्य पातः भवति. प्रैड् कम्स् बिफोर् अ फाल्. सो इन् अ मेनर् दट् ही केनाट् गेट् अप् अगेन् ही फाल्स् इन् सच् अ मेनर् दट् ही केनाट् गेट् अप् अगेन्. सो दट् इस् द सेकेण्ड् लैन्. सो एव्रिथिङ्ग् इस् एन् एड्जेक्टिव् टु दट् पर्सन् हू इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु हेव् अ फाल्, हू इस् फालिङ्ग्. So from his position, what is that? Hantum pravrittasya, hantum eva pravrittasya. Hantum ityukte nasham kartum illa, inge vandu himsam kartum, so torturing or making some sort of a mischief. So one who is bent upon torturing others, stabdhasya, who is arrogant, stabdaha garvitaha garvitasya vivaraishinaha, vivaram is looking for any loophole that is there in another person, which is a fault. Always continuously looking for faults in another person. Hantumeva pravrtasya, constantly making mischief. Stabdhasya, garvitasya. Tasya, tadrishasya, purushasya, pataha, tatha jayate. His fall will be in such a manner that he cannot again get up. It is his time, so he is creating such a mischief and torturing others. But there will come a time when he will fall from his position. He will fall with such a hard, you know, thud that he cannot get up again. That's the meaning of this shlokam. Atra pum vyanjanasyapi pratitihi. The entire thing is vrida janakam. That is the vulgar meaning that comes to our mind is, imagine asya. In place of asya, you will have to think of pum vyanjanam or the male part. So I think you should read the Vyakhyanam for this. It's
எப்படி
better
இப்படி
than right.
யோசிக்கிறா
Yeah.
இவள்லாம் சஹிருதயாளா
அப்படி இல்ல சஹிருதயா see it can convey a vulgar meaning என்ன பண்றது
ஓ நிஜமா எனக்கு கூட இப்படி தோணல
உனக்கு கூட புரியறதுங்கிறியா
எனக்கு கூட தோணலன்றேன்
தோணலங்கிறியா என்ன பண்றது So read the Vyakhyanam for the meaning. So there are a lot of innuendos that you can get from this. I don't want to. It completely describes the intercourse in vivid manner. Okay. So with this, artha doshas are over. Yatra ekaha doshaha pradarshitaha, where one dosha, where one fault is being highlighted, tatra doshantarani api santi. Just like how we saw in that lagnam raga vritangya, we saw some 3-4 doshas in that. There can be other doshas also in each and every shloka that we have highlighted. This looks like this dosha. This may be punarukta dosham. We can find out faults, many faults in one dosha. But he is not, is the aim of Kavya Prakashakara Mammata is not to point out or not to critically analyze shlokas. His aim is to highlight the dosha and to tell you where it is present in the lakshya. That's all. So doshantarani api santi, there may be other faults also in one particular shloka that I might have said. Tathapi tesham tatra aprakritatvat. In my context of the text, it is irrelevant. So I have not highlighted. Prakashanam na kritam. Okay, with this, the artha doshas are over. So in keeping with the topic, it is doshanam adoshatvam is our next topic. So the first, as we are doing artha dosha, he is going to point out where a dosham, which could be a dosham, is actually not a dosha. Karnavatamsadi pade karnadi dhvani nirmiti hi 1 minute I will take
karika
yes okay so karnavatamsadi pade karnadi dhvani nirmiti hi sannidhanadi bodhartham it ends with the 78th karika there is a sutram where it ends with something else so let's go when we come to that karna avatamsadi pade Karnadi dhvani nirmitihi sannidhanadi bodhartham. So this is the first doshanam adoshatvam that he starts off with. Karna avatamsadi pade. In the words that indicate karna avatamsa, ear ring. Avatamsam itself means ear ring and karna means ear. So it is like a punarukta dosham. But it is not punarukta dosham because an ear ring To indicate that the earring is actually placed in the karna and it is not just in the hand or it is present in my dresser. That's not the point that he wants to say. Or, you know, someone is giving the avatamsam. Karna avatamsam means it is being placed in the ear to show that karne sthitatvam, that is, it is present there. Karnadi dhvani nirmitihi nirmitihi prayogaha upadanam karnadi shabdasya upadanam tu sannidhanadi bodhartham sannidhyam or tatsthitatvam karnasthiti it is present in the ear sannidhyam means for dhanurjya he will say later so if it seems like there is a repetition of word there could be an explanation for it and when it does not become a dosha are the sthalams that he are the places that he is going to highlight now so avatamsadini karnadi aabharanani eva uchyante avatamsa or shekhara there is another kundalam is also it is worn by men in the ear that is called kundalam avatamsa is worn by women so avatamsadini karnadi abharanani eva they are the ornaments of the ear etc तत्र कर्णादि शब्दाः कर्णादि स्थिति प्रतिपत्तये, दट् इस् टु मेक् गिव् अस् दि अण्डर्स्टाण्डिङ्ग् दट् इट् इस् प्रेसेण्ट् अट् इन् दि इयर् अण्ड् नाट् जस्ट् केप्ट् इन् द हेण्ड्. एक्साम्पल्, अस्याः कर्णावतंसेन जितं सर्वं विभूषणं तथैव शोभते अत्यर्थम् अस्याः श्रवणकुण्डलम्. सो कुण्डलम् केन् बि वोर्न् बै बोत् मेन् अण्ड् विमेन्, बट् अवतंस इस् ओन्ली वोर्न् बै विमेन्. सो अस्याः कर्णावतंसेन बै हर् इयर् रिङ्ग् सर्वं विभूषणं जितम्, आल् दि अदर् आर्नमेण्ट्स् हेव् बीन् वन् ओवर् बै हर् इयर् रिङ्ग्. तथैव इन् द सेम् मेनर् अस्याः श्रवणकुण्डलम् अत्यर्थं शोभते, श्रवणे यत् कुण्डलं विद्यते तत् अत्यर्थं शोभते, एण्ड् द कुण्डलं दट् इस् देर् इन् हर् इयर् दट् इस् आल्सो वेरि ब्यूटिफुल्. सो ऐ वुड् थिङ्क् कर्णावतंसम् इस् एनी फ्लवर् विच् इस् बीन् पुट् इन् द इयर् एण्ड् कुण्डलं केन् बि इन् द फार्म् आफ् जस्ट् दट् रौण्ड् शेप् इयर् रिङ्ग् इस् अ कुण्डलम्. कर्ण अवतंसम् केन् बि एनी इयर् रिङ्ग्, ऐ एम् नाट् श्योर् बट् let's go with this. So asyaha karnavatam chalu.
Okay, so kundalam and avatamsa id vevera nu solraala andha shlokathla illa ore idha da solraala ore piece of aabharana.
No, I think they are talking about two different types of the ornaments.
Ne thodu thongata mariya.
Aama,
sorry, romba
correct ah sonna thodu thongata. Both actually are like, yeah. குண்டலம்ங்கிறது வந்து தொங்கிறது
தான்
மாதிரி, you know, it's that shape of it. அதனால தான் even men wear it. ஜிமிக்கின் இல்ல, பட் ஏன்னா கர்ணனுக்கு வந்து குண்டலம் தானே, கவச குண்டலம் தானே.
ஜஸ்ட் இது ரெண்டுத்துக்கும் என்ன வித்தியாசம் புரிஞ்சுக்க மாதிரி
அவதம்சாங்கிறது, even pushpam which is kept in the year is avatamsam. Shakuntala's aabharanam, right? You don't say that as kundalam.
Okay,
appo karnavatamsam angarche that which is hung in the year abdingra arthathla vandru.
Okay,
so anything can be an avatamsa, but everything cannot be kundalam.
Sari.
So asyaha karnavatamsena jitam sarvam vibhushanam, all the ornaments have been won over by this. So the earring has defeated all the ornaments. The same way, so you can say tathaiva in that manner, it shines forth very beautifully, or it can mean the same thing, one and the same. Apurva madhura amoda pramoda dishaha tataha आययुः भृङ्गमुकराः शिरःशेखरशालिनः. शिरःशेखरशालिनः शिरसि शेखरतया चूडामणिरूपेण अथवा शिरो अलङ्काररूपेण शालिनः भृङ्गमुकुराः, शिरो अलङ्काररूपेण मधुकराः वर्तन्ते ते. ततः ऐ थिङ्क् फ्रम् द लेडीस् फेस् ततः पोटर्क् आययुः, सारी पुरुषाहान्नु पोट्टिरुक्कु, पुरुषाः आययुः तच्छालिनः, करेक्ट्. सो दोस् अपूर्व मधुर आमोद प्रमोदित दिशः शिरशेखर शालिनः भृङ्गमुखराः पुरुषाः आययुः, शिरशेखर शालिनः पुरुषाः आययुः. योर् अन्वयम् इस् लैक् दिस्. सो अपूर्व द मेन् आर् हेविङ्ग् फ्लवर्स् on their head, that is like an alankaram for their head. Shira shekharataya bhasate bhasante pushpani. So that tadrisha shalinaha means those who have that shirobhushanam, those people, and that shirobhushanam is actually because it is flowers, all the bees are all making a noise around their face or around them, the men themselves, and they are spreading amoda fragrance in all directions. Apurva madhura, apura unique, and madhura sweet smell is being pramodita all the directions, dik, all the directions are pramodita, made happy with the fragrance which is sweet and unique. Those people are coming, ayayuhu. Now let's The context here is Karna, Shravana, Shirash Shabdaha, Sannidhana Pratityarthaha. So here Avatamsa is actually a Karnabharanam to indicate that it is present in the Karnam, in the ear, and it is beautiful. So he specifies Karna Avatamsa. The same way Shravane Eva Kundalam Daryate, but when you say Shravana Kundalam, it is more, it shows the beauty or utkarsham of the Adharaha. The person who is wearing it in the ear is also so beautiful. In order to emphasize the beauty of the ear, you are saying Shravana Kundalam and not just a Kundalam that is present on the table. So the same way the third word also, Shekharaha is a Shiro Bhushanam, which you don't, Shekhara is not a Bhushanam that you wear anywhere else. It is not a mala. Shekhara is only that which is worn on the head. So when you use the word Shiraha, it is not just that they have it in their hand or they just own that Shiro Bhushanam. They are actually wearing it on their head. So it is a form of specifying, being more specific. Next is for Sannidhanam. Vidirna Abhimukha Arati Karale Sangarantare Dhanurjya Kinachinnena Doshna Vispuritam Tava. Hey Rajan, Kavi is addressing the king and saying, Tava Doshna Vispuritam Dhanurjya Kinachinnena Doshna Vispuritam. Your bhujam is shining forth in this place. So doshna vispuritam means tava bhujaha spurati. Your arms are throbbing. How is that arm? Dhanurjya kina chinnena. It has the chinnam mark of the kina, a wound that has been made by the dhanurjya, the string, the bow string. The bow string attached to the bow. So here the bowstring makes a mark on your shoulder and your shoulder is throbbing because of that chinham. Where Sangarante in the battlefield, Vidirna Abhimukha Arati Karale. So first your arms had Vidirna, it had killed all the Arati, the enemies who were Abhimukha, who were standing in front of you and looking very Karalam in So the yuddham was karalam or bhayankaram. Bhayankare yudde shatravaha abhimuke tishtanti tan shatrun vidirnaha bhujaha. So that your arm had killed all the enemies who were standing in front and it was a very terrible battle. In that battle, dhanurjya kinachinhena doshna vispuritam. This bhave prayogam is difficult to translate in English. Atra dhanush shabdaha arudatva avagataye. This is important. So just by the maurvi or jya or gunaha, these are words which are very specific to bow strings. So when you say dhanur jya and you are qualifying it with the word dhanushaha jya, it means dhanushi Yukta Jya. It has been connected and he has fought with the bow which has the string connected to it. So Arudhatvam Jya Dhanushi Arudha Iti Tatra Avagatihi. Puriyardulya. Anyatratu Jyabandha Nishpanda Bhujena Yasya Vinishwasad Vaktra Paramparena. Yes, tell me. Oh, I have muted. Okay. Yeah, now unmute yourself and ask.
So Akka, but the jya cannot be it has to be in the dhanuho only, right? So why dhanurjya again? Isn't it like paunarukti again? Like
that's see, it's in the jya. In the dhanus, that is fine, but it is only tied on one end always, no? You have to take it up and tie it on the other end. Then only it will be useful for throwing the arrow, shooting the arrow.
Oh, that way. Okay.
So, arodhatvam means the other side has also been tied tightly so that it is ready for battle.
Okay.
So just with the mere string, you see that the jya kinam could have also happened when he is just practicing or doing something like that. But here specifically, he has used it for shooting the arrows to the enemy. So that's why the first line of explanation is also needed here. So maybe when he was trying to tie it also, that kinam could have happened. But dhanurjya, ityukte dhanushi arudha jaya gunena. Because, so that to specify that, he says. Chale.
So in the madri, solra dalna these. புனருக்திஹி விச் இஸ் நாட் அ தோஷான்னா வந்து காவியம் காவியத்துல அலௌட் பட் ஆனா இப்போ வேத வாக்கியம்னு சொல்றச்சு அவ வந்து ரொம்ப கராரா இருப்பா இல்லையா இந்த மாதிரி எல்லாம் வந்து ஈவன் லிட்டில் திங்ஸ் எல்லாம் விடாத
அங்கேயும் ஈவன் இன் வேத வாக்கியம் யூ ஹேவ் த எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் ஆஃப் அர்த்தவாத
ஓகே சரி அது ரேட் அவ கன்வீனியன்டா ஒன்னு சொல்லிட்டாங்க
எஸ் அர்த்தவாத இஸ் தேர் சோ விச் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் சேயிங் இட் இன் பிரேஸ் ஆஃப் சம்திங் தாதிருஷ உத்கிருஷ்ட ஜியா அஸ்தி அப்படின்னு போட்டுப்போம் வேத வாக்கியத்துல சரியா இதோட நிறுத்திப்போமா வில் ஸ்டாப் வித் திஸ் அண்ட் கண்டினியூ